Welcome, everyone, to Cinema Spotlight, where I talk about a director's filmography from their first to their most recent. Here I am on Peter Jackson's work, the man who adapted J.R.R. Tolkien's The Lord of the Rings into three prestigious films. The experience going into this, the extended reviews, is no different than watching the theatrical, only you just have a little bit more to look at. Different exposition points, new dialogue within the same scene, extended scenes, fleshed out character development that help with later scenes, and the list goes on. Talking to you about this won't be a rehash of me talking about the plot or vaguely mentioning how the technical craft is astounding. This will be talking points on what I believed were great within the extended edition, what I felt should have made it to the theatrical, what scenes I loved originally, and what scenes I loved in the extended. More or less, I get to gush about the film and be a complete nerd. Without further ado, let's get into the first segment. This one's pretty simple. Honestly, Gimli trying to keep up with Aragorn and Legolas was absolutely hilarious.
Keep breathing. That's the key. Breathe.
Gandalf extracting Saruman's influence from Theoden was badass, and watching the transformation to this, was awesome to watch. The practical work as well as the emotional payoff really makes for emotional storytelling. I know I don't go on about music in any of my reviews because I often forget, but this truly needs a shout out considering between all three of these films, they all have a stellar soundtrack. I can't play any of the music on here, but look up the Two Towers soundtrack, The King of the Golden Hall. You won't regret it. It's the worst kept secret in these films that Gandalf comes back. The best part about Gandalf's death is that his resurrection doesn't mess around with the emotional loss of the first film. Organically placed back into the plot, we watch Gandalf the White be better than ever. However, I'm still more of a fan of Gandalf the Grey. I said in my theatrical review that the Helm's Deep battle is intense. I also said that when watching it, I felt that there was no way you could top this battle in intensity. That still reigns true. Even though the Siege of Minas Tirith is bolder and more epic in scale, it has its intensity, but Helm's Deep is just a little bit better. It's almost a sneak attack against Rohan against mutant orcs. An excellent dive into Sméagol's character as he wrestles with his dual persona, Gollum. You can clearly tell that he's not all there, but he struggles with what he wants, how he wants to get it, and how to get it. I love how the scene was shot, showing both sides of Sméagol and Gollum arguing with himself. Through mannerisms, dialogue, even the eyes that were dilated from Sméagol to Gollum, you can really tell who is who. Just when things can't get any worse for Frodo, he damn near sacrifices himself, giving up the ring. Sam saves Frodo from the unfathomable sacrifice, but Frodo pulls Thing out ready to kill Sam. Frodo snaps out of it and confesses that he can't do this anymore. That's where Sam lays it all out in one amazing speech.
But there's some good in this world, Mr. Frodo, and it's worth fighting for.
Between the loss of Theoden's son and Wormtongue making nothing better, Eowyn storms out to survey the lands just to get away from the torment. Below, she sees the city, off across the distance, Legolas, Gimli, Aragorn, and Gandalf riding towards them. A beautiful moment for sure, especially with the music swelling and conveying the desperate time and how a solution may be coming. We have only now met Theoden after introducing him completely subdued by Wormtongue's antics. Once he finds out his son is dead, despite not really knowing Theoden very well at this moment, is truly something worth noting here. I understand his pain, though I do not relate to it. I am sad for him, even though I didn't know his son. I feel for him because he has woken up to something he does not know how to handle just yet. The fact that time is taken to establish him and give you time to empathize with him makes me understand the decisions he is making for the rest of the film. We are given time to grieve with Theoden. Instead of rushing to the next scene that may provide humor, we are hammered in with another factor that Theoden has to act towards. It starts relatively around the battle for Helm's Deep, and in the theatrical version, we never really reach an ultimate climax or resolution to this competition of killing orcs and Uruk-hai. But the extended edition does show a sort of resolution to that, and we're going to get into why that this is one of the scenes that I felt should have been kept in the theatrical.
He was already dead.
He was twitching.
He was twitching? Because he's got my axe embedded in his nervous system!
Diving into the next topic, here we go. Gonna be doing a two-for-one deal here, as I'll tell you my favorite extended scenes, and I'll also tell you if that scene should have been kept in the theatrical or not. This established the stakes, personality, and tone of the film a lot better than the theatrical version, in my opinion. This opening has more of a sense of humor, which I appreciated as well. I really think this is one of them that should have been kept in the theatrical. The first time we see Sméagol's split personality is towards the middle of the film. Here, we see it early on, and we know there's an immediate conflict, giving Sméagol's banishment of Gollum more context and a lot more weight. Éomer finding the king's son and traveling back to Rohan kept the intensity of Saruman's presence in the forefront, adding more personality to Éomer and also information along with the desperation for the family to stay alive. Much needed context as to how Gandalf will fulfill the role of the lead wizard in turn of Saruman's treachery. Simply put, this adds more personality to Gandalf as he comes back and kind of weighs himself back into who he was but who he's supposed to be as a new man. Oof, this is a hard hitter for sure. Eowyn singing as they bury Theodred towards the end of the scene is painful. We may never have known Theodred, but the pain everyone else feels is definitely real. With this scene, it's sort of a recap of everything we know and insight of what Gandalf knows since coming back. The best piece of news Gandalf receives is knowing that Samwise went with Frodo to destroy the ring. This is the kind of stuff that I wish was kept in the theatrical cut because it adds a sense of camaraderie between these two. I really think this one, above all else, should have been kept in. Theoden has an affinity for Eowyn and is cherishing a moment he gets to see that doesn't happen often. Her smiling is a rare occurrence, and sadly, Theoden's reflection on why she doesn't smile, because things often turn to grief, this is one of the scenes that I wish hadn't been cut as well. This was a detail I didn't notice until after watching it years and years later down the road. Took me long enough, but like Gimli's gift of Galadriel's hair, this scene really means a lot to me just as much. Just putting two and two together. Brego was the horse that he let go, and Brego was the horse that rescued Aragorn. It just, how did I not catch that? The extended edition of Two Towers provides more personality to the characters more than anything else. Where Fellowship does the same, I feel the world expanded with them in that version. Here, Towers gets more personality as a whole. I felt that Towers was a trimmed-down masterwork, just giving off just a bit of its mystic wonder. After this extended edition, I felt much more elated, feeling as if I got to see something I should have seen long ago. Guys and gals, in the end, this extended edition is not to be missed. If you could care less about runtime, love this world, and want to see more of it, then I would definitely recommend this edition for you. This is where I pass off the question to you. What are your favorite moments in Lord of the Rings: The Two Towers? What are some of your favorite extended moments? Which ones of these you wish stayed in the theatrical cut, and which ones would you take or leave? Let me know in the comments. Thank you all so much for watching. If you like this, please like, comment, and subscribe. And with all that said, have a fantastic and wonderful day. Until next time.